The Austin American Statesman released this photo. They obtained this photo, and if you look closely at that, what you can see is you can see a police officer inside the building with a ballistic shield. And again, if you look closely, there are two others there with rifles. This picture was time-stamped at 11:52 a.m., 19 minutes after the shooter first entered the school, but a full 58 minutes before law enforcement ultimately breached the classroom door and took out the shooter. We had not seen an image like this before. Joining me now is Jose Flores Sr. His 10-year-old son, Jose Flores Jr., was one of the victims killed in the Uvalde shooting. Jose, thank you for being with us. I can't imagine how hard it is for you to see these images as they're released for the very first time. But tell me what you think when you look at that picture.
I mean, it's... I feel anger. I mean, that's not right. I mean, cowards, they let our kids down, left them in there scared and who knows, crying, and they abandoned them, just like one of the teachers said in his interview, policemen abandoned the kids and his class as soon as they heard gunshots. They're supposed to be, I mean, trained professionals, bulletproof vests, you know, heavy automatic weapons in their cars. I don't understand the reason why they stood back that long for them to go back in. I mean, somebody has to pay for it. Somebody have fought for this, our kids' lives being taken. I mean, the chief, they still have the chief. And they haven't fired him. He's still in the office. Something has to be done. Police officers that were there too, I mean, I don't know. They're at fault for it. Uvalde PD is at fault for it. For our kids' lives being taken away. Standing back a whole hour, leaving them inside with that gunman. It's not right. It's cowardly stuff, man.
We hadn't seen the ballistic shield before, certainly not at 11:52. We hadn't seen the long rifles, certainly not at 11:52. What does it tell you that they were there for 58 minutes?
Yes, and that's not right, because they're lying to the public saying they didn't have the right equipment, that's what they were waiting for, and that's why they stood back, because they didn't have the right equipment, and a lot of dumb excuses, you know, and it's slowly showing their error, and that's what they're trying to cover up, because it was their error. I mean, hopefully it all comes out and somebody pays for it, because I mean, it took our kid lives. We gotta pay for the rest of our lives, seeing our kids not here anymore. I gotta wake up in the morning and not have my son come to me because of their error. Like, it's not right.
I also want to note that your son, Jose Jr., he wanted to be a police officer.
Yes.
How hard has it been for you to get answers?
I mean, they're not saying anything at all. They're not telling us nothing. They're just excuses. They're trying to cover up their tracks. They're getting lawyers or something to represent the Uvalde County for them not to get evidence, not give them any of the information. So, I mean, they haven't really said anything much. And after every time they have meetings in the city, they don't let nobody in. So how are we supposed to get answers? They just let the officers in or whoever's having the meeting in there. They don't let no cameraman, they don't let us in. They kick us out like the one from yesterday. I wasn't there, but I heard about it.
What do they say to you? What do they say to you? What do they say to you when you try to get answers?
No, I'm not really worried about it. I mean, because it's all going to come out soon, and it's coming out. Because it's their mistake. Somebody's mistakes has always come out. So, I mean, they're coming out slowly. So I'm just, within time, it all comes out. I mean, I don't have time to be looking around. I'm just, trying to get through it one day at a time. My son not being here is more important than worrying about other stuff.
Tell us how you are getting through the days right now.
I mean, I'm going back to work, distract the mind, keep busy. Because, I mean, I had my son since he was 10, all day, every day he was with me. And now, for 10 years he was with me, now I don't. So I got to get used to not having him being around me. It's kind of hard, but I got to do it for my other kids. I got more kids, so I can't let them see me down.
I'm sure they know that you are there for them. And I'm also sure that they are there for you. What do you want to see happen in the coming days and weeks?
I mean, action. Somebody has to pay for this. I mean, that chief is still on duty. I mean, that's a joke. That's like laughing at our faces, still having him in there after he has 21 lives under him for his nonsense actions. And then the officers, I mean, they were just following orders. But I'm pretty sure if one of those officers had kids, a child in that room, he would have not took that order. He would still went in there. But I mean, I want to just see somebody's error was made there, and they got to pay for that error, because we're paying it for the rest of our lives, not seeing our kids grow up, you know, graduate, be a father, you know, like we don't get to see that from them.
When you say you want them to pay, pay how?
I mean, he has 21 charges, 21 lives under his under him. So I mean, murder charges. There you go, 21 murder charges. Kate counts like something. Go to jail. Like he made it. We gotta pay for the rest of our lives, not seeing our kids. Like that's not right. Just for his simple error. Like that's not right. Like he was just seeing it as a simple error. No, it's a big time error. Like took 21 lives. In prison time for his life, something, not just being fired, because that's just laughing at our faces. Just fire him. He needs to go to do his lifetime too. Like that's not right.
Jose, before we let you go, can you just tell us about your son, what kind of kid he was?
Yes, he was always happy kid, man, like a smiling all the time. I mean, he loved being outdoors. He loved playing baseball, video games. He liked to be adventurous. He would pick certain random stuff up from the floor, little rocks, sticks. Like, he was adventurous. He just happy kid to be around. Like, he was a big, good big brother. I mean, he hated school so much. I mean, I wish I did not send him to school that day, but I was trying to get him to learn, have his learns. Because he wanted to be a policeman, so I was on him to be good grades, be at school every day. And school he hated so much, thinking he was safe at the school. Look what happened. You know.
Jose, again, we're so sorry.
Yeah.
He should be on summer vacation with you right now.
Yes.
I know he is in your thoughts, he is in your prayers, and always will be. Jose Flores Sr., thank you for being with us. Know that we are thinking about you.